We've seen these rocket launches around the world from various different countries. What is Japan attempting to do?
So Japan is attempting to send a robotic lander to the moon. No people aboard. Japan has had this project in the works for a while. There, it was supposed to launch late last month. They had to put it off several times because of bad weather. This mission is called the Smart Lander for investigating the moon. It would be a breakthrough because it would be landing with a much more in a much more precise area. So would, if successful, would enable Japan and NASA and others that work with the Japanese Space Agency to do much much more defined landings on the moon with a better sense of exactly where they're going to be heading to. Where they're going to, and here we are, we're seeing it's off right now.
Yeah, in fact, we're just going to watch this as, of course, Japan becomes the latest country to aim for the moon this weekend. We have the launch. Japan, after a number of setbacks, now successfully launching that H-IIA rocket this morning. This is a large payload rocket that was initially scheduled to launch on August 26, but it had been delayed three times on concerns over bad weather. It carries with it an advanced imaging satellite and a lunar lander that's slated to reach the moon as early as January. And this is really, you know, both scientifically and symbolically important for Japan. Right, we've spoken about, you know, this sort of reignition, if you will, of interest in lunar exploration with the Russian spacecraft, of course, not successful, and India's efforts as well. We've also seen, Bruce, a lot more energy, I guess, and momentum in private space enterprises and technology. How does, I guess, the broader organization and investment play into that?
Well, you're right. In fact, there was a Japanese company, iSpace, that made an attempt to land on the moon earlier this year. And had they succeeded, they would have been the first private sector company to successfully land on the moon. Unfortunately for them, it didn't work. They are going to try again, though. That was part of a series of setbacks that Japanese companies and or the space agency have had over the past year. They've had a few failures. So it's especially important for JAXA, the Japanese Space Agency, that this one work this time.
Well, they are making good progress so far after those multiple delays. We are seeing that H-IIA rocket from Japan bound for the moon, taking off successfully and clearing that launch tower. It carries a small lander for investigating the moon, as well as X-ray imaging and other technology. So hugely important for Japan, both scientifically and symbolically.